Just nu pågår en global revolution inom anatomisk forskning som i grunden förändrar vår syn på människokroppen.
The way of thinking how anatomy and body of course is changing.
Det handlar om fascia, ett nätverk av bindväv som omsluter allt i kroppen, som till alldeles nyligen inte ansågs betydelsefullt, men som 2017 blev erkänt som kroppens största organ.
So fascia is let's say almost one third of our biomechanics.
Den nya insikten har lett till en löpeld av nya upptäckter som börjar utmana våra konventionella uppfattningar om människokroppen.
Historically I'm a pathologist, so I sit looking at human tissues under the microscope all day long. That's not the same as looking at living tissue, though we pretend it is. But now we have a scope that looks at the living tissue and it doesn't look like what we thought.
In your first year of medical school, you get a cadaver and they cut it up and you have to scrupulously tag everything as you're studying the body. The fascia you can throw in the garbage can. So it's almost like we're trained to not pay attention to it.
På Fascia Research Congress i Berlin presenterades de senaste upptäckterna. Bland annat så har Carla Stecco hittat en helt ny cell med stor betydelse för vår rörelseförmåga, och många i publiken menar att hon borde få Nobelpris i medicin.
We have discovered a new cell inside the fascia that we have called the fasciocytes that has a different behavior and is able to create the gliding surface of the different fascia.
You know, when the patient comes in to the physician and says, I think I have a problem in my fascia, they'll be like, they'll look it up on Google and they'll find us.
På kongressen presenterades nya perspektiv och förklaringar till vanliga problem och sjukdomar, som ryggvärk, övervikt, diabetes och till och med cancer. Och kanske är det så vi hittar nya svar genom att se på kroppen på ett helt nytt sätt.
It's all the same human body. And we just have different perspectives on it. And I think part of what's going on here, if we're all talking about the same body, then maybe the issues that separate us are all about language and metaphor. I think this kind of work is starting to allow us to see where they meet. And if that happened, then you'd be talking about global medicine and global health rather than Western versus Eastern and that kind of thing.